Hi, my name is Sapta, and I'm a senior product manager at AWS. Welcome to the demo series on how to build a weather station using AWS ExpressLink. For those who are new to ExpressLink, it is a connectivity software that powers a range of hardware modules developed and offered by AWS partners such as Expressive, Infineon, and uBlox. These connectivity modules include AWS validated software, which makes it faster and easier for you to securely connect almost any product to the cloud in a fraction of time and cost. Products include medical devices, industrial sensors, and consumer goods. Developers of all skill levels can quickly and easily transform their products into IoT devices without having to merge large amounts of code or have a deep understanding of the underlying implementation. The connectivity modules come pre-provisioned with security credentials, allowing developers to offload the complex networking and cryptography tasks to the module and develop secure IoT products in weeks rather than months. Modules that use AWS IoT Express Link are pre-programmed to seamlessly integrate with over 200 AWS IoT services, including AWS IoT Core. Please visit our product catalog page, which is in the description link below. In addition to building the weather station, we will show you how with a few lines of code, you can easily connect, send, and receive data from AWS. In the following video of this demo series, you will learn how to build a weather station using the required hardware. In the third video, we will demonstrate the ease of writing a simple source code with few lines using ExpressLink to build a weather station. In the fourth video, we will go through the steps to add an ExpressLink module to an AWS IoT console and show real-time data. In the fifth video, we will store data on the AWS time stream with just one line of SQL code. And lastly, in the final video, we will demonstrate how to visualize data using Amazon Managed Grafana. So without further ado, let me introduce our technical experts.
Hi, my name is Dan Gross, and I am a senior developer advocate for AWS IoT and FreeRTOS. In this video series, we'll be exploring hands-on engineering and how we use ExpressLink deploying a weather station into the field. We'll see some hardware, some software, and some cloud.
Hi, my name is Joe Julisher, and I am a senior software development engineer on ExpressLink at AWS. I will be working alongside Dan and Sapta to showcase how quickly and easily we've been able to build the weather station using ExpressLink and manage the data.
So here we have the weather station sketch that runs on the Arduino Uno. You can see in the setup function that we have a number of commands that configure the ExpressLink module, and these are only needed to run once. Here you can configure the endpoint, the topic, the SSID, and the passphrase. Once those are configured, you don't need to run those again. And so, we'll comment them out. Then you can see in the setup command, we have the AT connect. Now, when the board starts up, the setup function will run, and the serial connection will then connect to the ExpressLink. Here, we connect by issuing the command AT plus connect. It's that simple. Now, when we want to send data, we go to the send weather function in the Arduino sketch, and here we have AT plus connect again, just to make sure that we're still connected, and then we issue AT plus send one over the serial. And there, we send all of our weather station data in JSON format. And that's all you need to do.
You just heard how simple it is to set up the software to communicate with an ExpressLink to make the connections to the cloud. Very quickly, I want to show an example of the connections needed from the host microcontroller to an ExpressLink device to actually show the hardware connections. So this particular schematic you see on screen is a design I'm doing for a different project for the Open Hardware Group. And this one is using a ESP32C3 based ExpressLink from Espressif. In this design, you see this is the the minimum connections needed. We have just a couple of bypass capacitors for power filtering. This design needs to have a 32 kilohertz crystal oscillator for timekeeping purposes. It helps when you're doing the sleep command, and also it maintains a real-time clock inside the ExpressLink for validating certificates and other security functions. And then there's the connections to the host processor. The connections to the host processor at a minimum are just the receive and the transmit signals. But for a more advanced application, you will also want the event for getting synchronous events back from the ExpressLink, like a connect or a disconnect. You also want a wake and a reset. The wake is so that you can wake up an ExpressLink that you have put to sleep. You might put an ExpressLink to sleep to save power. And then you'll use the reset signal if something were to go wrong, or and you need to reset the ExpressLink all the way back to its initial states. Not the factory reset. This will just be a power on reset. So those are all the signals. Putting that schematic down next to your existing host processor, hooking up these five connections allows your ExpressLink to enable an IoT connection to AWS for any host processor out there. We've even connected this to something like the PIC10F 200, which only has six I/O pins and 64 bytes of RAM. And ExpressLink was able to get that simplistic application all the way to the cloud.
Thanks, Dan and Joe, for introducing us to AWS ExpressLink and showing how simple it is to use.